Hello friends, myself Dr. Deepak Kumar Dwivedi, Assistant Professor in Department of Zoology, DBE College. Today I am going to talk about a new topic of evolution, and this is Neo-Darwinism and modern concept of evolution. So Neo-Darwinism, actually it is a modified form of Darwin's theory of natural selection, that is the restatement of the concept of evolution by natural selection in terms of Mendelian as well as post-Mendelian genetics. The important features of Neo-Darwinism are number one, rapid multiplication. Means that all organisms multiply in a geometrical ratio, that is they produce more offspring than can survive. Next is limited food and space. And since limited food and space are limited, therefore the size of the population remain constant. Third is struggle for existence, and struggle for existence actually it is the competition for the primary requirement. These requirements may arise due to excessive multiplication by the parents and limited space and food supply among the offspring for their requirements, and they can be divided into three types. That is, these struggles are three types. First is interspecific struggle, second is intraspecific struggle, and number three, environmental struggle. Now, fourth is genetic variations. So genetic variations are, these are the inheritable variations which may occur because of following reasons: because of mutation, that is chromosomal and gene mutations, gene recombinations, hybridization, and genetic drift. Now fifth is natural selection, and it occurs through the differential reproduction, that is few individuals produce abundant offsprings, some produce only a few and other none. If such reproduction continues for many generations, the genes of the individual which produce more offsprings will become predominant in the gene pool of the population. Next is isolation, and isolation is the segregation or separation of population by some barriers which produce interbreeding. Thus, reproduction isolation between the population due to some barriers leads to the formation of new species. That is speciation. Now, seventh and next important feature is the origin of new species. An isolated population of a species independently develops different types of mutations and accumulate it in its gene pool. After many generations, the isolated population will become genetically and reproductively different from others and finally leads to the formation of new species. Therefore, according to Neo-Darwinism, there are four basic steps of organic evolution. First is appearance of genetic variability. Second is spread of genetic variability. Third is the reproductive isolation, and then fourth is accumulation of genetic variability leading to speciation. Now, differences between Darwinism and Neo-Darwinism. So, Darwinism basically is concerned with, that is the theory of Darwin, original theory. This was the original theory or natural selection. So, which was given by Darwin in 1859 in his book. To explain origin of new species, but Neo-Darwinism is a modified theory of Darwin. Now, in Darwinism, actually accumulation of continuous variations create new species. According to neo-Darwinism, continuous variations and mutation both responsible for speciation. According to old theory of Darwinism, that is the selection of individual on the basis of accumulation of variation. But in according to neo-Darwinism, variations accumulate in gene pool and not in the individual. According to old theory, because this theory does not believe in isolation, but neo-Darwinism actually tells that isolation as an essential component of evolution. Old theory cannot explain the origin of new character, but this can explain the origin of new character, but neo-Darwinism cannot explain the origin of new characters. Old theory cannot explain the persistence of certain forms in the unchanged condition, but neo-Darwinism can explain the occurrence of unchanged forms over millions of years. This is the differences between Darwinism and neo-Darwinism. Now come to modern concept of evolution, and this is the recent concept, and according to this concept, genetic variations appearing among the individuals of a population bring about evolution under the influence of natural selection and isolation. So there are four factors in the modern concept of evolution. Number one, genetic variation. Number two, natural selection. Number three, speciation. And number four, reproductive isolation. So genetic variations is the raw material of evolution. So you know that there are number one, genetic variations, actually it is the population that evolves, not its individual members, because the individuals come into being and perish, but the population continues and evolution requires many generations. The evolution, the individual's role in the evolutionary process is to pass on its genetic variation to its progeny, that is to contribute its specific genes in the gene pool of the population. Evolution occurs through the accumulation of genetic variations in population over a long period of time. The genetic variations are caused by environmental factors such as temperature, light, food, humidity, and genetic factors such as random distribution of homologous gene in meiosis, then crossing over, dual parentage, that is from both side of maternal and paternal, random union of gametes in fertilization, and it involves gene pool, that is the total gene content of a whole species, and in a gene pool the proportion of certain genes increases and that of others decreases. This variation is known as change in gene frequencies, and this change occurs in many ways. The gene migration, if the migrating individual interbreed with the members of local population, then it is known as hybridization, and these may bring many new alleles into the local gene pool of the host population, and this phenomenon is known as gene migration. And if the interspecific hybrid are fertile, then this may result in the formation of new species. The addition or removal of alleles when individuals enter or leave a population from another locality, it is known as gene flow. Unrestricted gene flow decreases the differences between the gene pool and reduces the distinctiveness between different populations. And non-random mating is what results in a deviation from the Hardy-Weinberg distribution. Most organisms have a limited dispersal capability, so their mate will be chosen from the local population. For example, the selection of more brightly colored male bird by a female bird may increase the gene frequency of bright color in next generation. Now, genetic drift or sewall right effect or scattering of variability, actually random fluctuation in the gene frequencies in a small population, generation after generation, purely by chance, is known as genetic drift. The gene of certain traits are eliminated when a section of population dies or migrates due to natural calamity. When it that is genetic drift alters the gene frequency of the remaining population. This concept was given by Sewell Wright in 1930. Therefore, it is also known as Sewall Wright effect. Like selection, it operates on populations, and unlike selection, it occurs in small population. Always influences frequencies of allele and inversely proportional to the size of population. It also operates through founder effect, that is, genetic drift can cause dramatic changes in the allele frequencies in a population derived from a small group of colonizer. These are known as founders to a new habitat. And the founders do not have all the alleles found in their source population, and they become quickly different from parental population and may form a new species. For example, the Afrikaner population of Dutch settlers in South Africa is descended mainly from few colonists, and today the Afrikaner's population has an unusually high frequency of the gene that causes Huntington's disease, because those original Dutch colonists just happened to carry that gene with unusually high frequency. This effect is easy to recognize in genetic diseases, but of course, the frequencies of all sorts of genes are affected by founder event. Now, the bottleneck effect, it has been observed that even if organisms do not move from place to place, occasionally their populations may be drastically reduced in size due to drought, flooding, epidemic disease, natural sources, etc. So, the few surviving individuals may constitute a random genetic sample of the original population. This you can see in the diagram. It is a parental population, and this is a bottleneck. There is drastic reduction in population. So, surviving individual, they form a new individual, and the number of such individual will be high in next generation. So, the resulting alternations alteration and loss of genetic variability is known as bottleneck effect. Therefore, it is the reduction of in allele frequencies caused by drastic reduction in population size, and in such phenomena is known as population crash. For example, northern elephant seals have reduced genetic variation probably because of a population bottleneck human inflicted on them in the 1890s, and hunting reduced their population size to as few as 20 individuals at the end of the 19th century. Their population has since rebounded to over 30,000, but their genes still carry the marks of this bottleneck. They have much less genetic variation than a population of southern elephant seal that was not so intentionally hunted. So next, mutation, which is major source of genetic variation, and it alters the base sequence in a gene or gene sequence in a chromosome. The second feature is this concept is natural selection. And natural selection, that it is the differential survival and reproduction of individual due to differences in phenotype. And it is a key mechanism of individual, the change in the heritable traits, characteristic of a population over generations, and it can be divided into following them. That is the type of natural selection. Number one is stabilizing selection. So here you can see that this is the graph of stabilizing selection. When selective pressures select against the two extremes of a trait, the population experiences stabilizing selection, right? For example, plant height might be acted on by stabilizing selection. A plant that is too short may not be able to compete with other plants for sunlight. However, extremely tall plant may be more susceptible to wind damage. Combine these two selection pressures select to maintain plants of medium height. The number of plants of medium heights will increase, while the number of short and tall plants will decrease. Now, number two is directional selection. This is the graph of directional selection, middle one. And in this one extreme of the trait distribution experiences selection against it, the result is that the population's trait distribution shift toward the other extreme. In the case of such selection, the mean of the population graph shift. For example, giraffe neck. There was a selection pressure against short necks, since individuals with short neck could not reach as many leaves on which they feed. As a result, the distribution of neck length shifted to favor individuals with long neck. This is the example of directional selection. Number three is disruptive. This is the graph of the disruptive selection. You can see in the plate. And in disruptive selection, actually, selection pressure act against individual in the middle of the trait distribution. And the result is a bimodal or two peaked curve in which the two extremes of the curve create their own smaller curves. And for example, imagine a plant of extremely variable height that is pollinated by three different pollinators. One that was attracted to short plants, another that preferred plants of medium height, and the third that visited only the tallest plants. If the pollinator that preferred plants of medium height disappeared from an area, medium height plants would be selected against and the population would tend towards both short and tall, but not medium height plants. Such a population in which multiple distinct forms or morphs exist is said to be polymorphic. Now, third feature of this concept, modern concept, is speciation. Means the formation of new and distinct species in the course of evolution. And speciation involves the splitting of a single evolutionary lineage into two or more genetically independent lineages. The process of splitting of genetically homologous homogeneous population into two or more populations that undergo genetic differentiation and eventual reproductive isolation is known as speciation. The entire course of evolution depends upon the origin of new population or species that have greater adaptive efficiency than their ancestors. So there are some types of speciation: allopatric, peripatric, parapatric, sympatric. So there are four types of speciation. So you can study here that first of all we will study the allopatric speciation. Here you can see in the diagram also these are the important bits regarding this. And allopatric speciation, actually it is the mode of speciation in which original population is divided into two by a barrier resulting in reproductive isolation. This one, for example, this is the original population. You can see in the diagram, and there is a geographic barrier. Then this geographic barrier divides this original species into two. So the formation of low fitness hybrid take place, secondary contact, then selection against hybrids. So divergence of mating associating traits. That you can see here, speciation take place. So the model for this speciation was presented by Meyer, and it is based on the concept that new species arise when some physical geographic barrier divides a large population of a species into two or more small populations. The individuals of these isolated population cannot interbreed because of their physical isolation. Physical isolation might occur either due to physical barriers like vast expanses of ocean, high mountains, glaciers, deep river valleys, wide rivers or deserts, or a considerable distance due to a larger geographical range. Each isolated population starts to adapt to their separated environment while accumulating differences and evolving independently into new species. This speciation can occur even in cases in which the barrier allows some individuals to cross the barrier to mate with the members of the other group. For speciation event to be considered, allopatric gene flow between the soon-to-be species must be significantly reduced, but it does not have to be entirely reduced to zero. For example, Darwin finches is the example of allopatric speciation. The divergent populations of finches inhabiting the Galapagos Islands were observed to have differences in features such as body size, color, beak length or shape. The differences resulted because of the different type of food available in various islands. Next is peripatric speciation. So peripatric speciation, actually it is a special condition of allopatric speciation when occurs. It occurs when the size of the isolated subpopulation is small. And in this case, in addition to geographic separation, genetic drift also plays an important as genetic drift acts more quickly in a small population. The small isolated subpopulation might carry some rare genes which upon reaching the new geographical region become fixed over the course of a few generations as a result of genetic drift. As a result, the entire population of the new region ends up having these rare genes. Over time, new genetic characters as well as natural selection cause the survival of individuals which are better suited to the climate and food of the new region. Finally, under the influence of all these factors, new species are formed. However, it is very difficult to explain what role genetic drift played in the divergence of the two populations, which makes gathering evidence to support or refute this mode very challenging. For example, the Australian bird, Petroica multicolor, and London underground mosquito, a variant of the mosquito Culex pipiens, which entered in the London underground in the 19th century. These are the examples of peripatric speciation. Now, third is the parapatric speciation. And parapatric speciation is such a speciation in which there is no extrinsic barrier in the population. But the large geographic range of the population causes the individual to mate with the neighboring individuals than with the individuals in a different part of the geographic range. So, in this case, the population is continuous, but the population does not meet randomly. Here, the genetic variations occur as a result of reduced gene flow within the population and varying selection pressures across the population range. This occurs in a population which is distributed over a large geographic range. Thus, the individuals in the far west region cannot mate with the individual in the far east region. Through a few generations, new species might be formed within the existing population. For example, the grass species Anthoxanthum arboretum, where some species living near the mine have become tolerant to heavy metals. However, other plants that do not live around the mines are not tolerant. But because the plants are close together, they could fertilize each other and result in a new species. Now, sympatric speciation, actually, this speciation is the process of formation of new speciation from an original population that are not geographically isolated. It is based on the establishment of new population of a species in different ecological niches and the productive isolation of founders of the new population from the individuals of the source population. Gene flow between daughter and parental population during sympatric speciation is postulated to be inhibited by intrinsic factors such as chromosomal changes and non-random mating. Exploiting a new niche might automatically reduce gene flow with the individuals exploiting a different niche. This mode of speciation is common in herbivore insects when they begin feeding and mating on a new plant, or when a new plant is introduced within the geographical range of the species, the gene flow is then reduced between the species that is lies in a particular plant, which might ultimately lead to the formation of new species. The selection resulting in specialization needs to be really strong for the population to diverge. Therefore, sympatric speciation is a sporadic event in multicellular organisms or randomly mating population. Example of sympatric speciation is observed in apple maggot flies, which 200 years old ago laid eggs and bred only on hawthorns, but now lays eggs on both hawthorns and domestic apples. As a result, gene flow between parts of the population that mate on different types of fruits is reduced, and in fewer than 200 years, some genetic differences between these two groups of the flies have evolved. Now, fourth feature of modern concept of evolution is reproductive isolation. So, what is this? Actually, a biological species is defined as a group of similar organisms able to interbreed to produce fertile, viable offspring. Biological species are reproductively isolated from one another. The definition is sometimes extended to require that such reproduction must occur under natural, not artificial, condition. Evolution of reproductive isolating mechanism prevents nascent species from interbreeding. So, isolating mechanism can be operated at two basic level. First is pre-zygotic mechanism. Second is post-zygotic mechanism. So, pre-zygotic mechanisms prevent formation of viable zygotes. So, first is ecological isolation. Two closely related species may occupy different ecosystem within a geographical region. So, it is known as ecological isolation. These are ecologically isolated if their habitat preferences lower their probability of mating. For example, Central California population of Rana species, the red-legged frog Rana draytonii tend to breed in large pond, and the yellow-legged frog Rana belli breeds almost exclusively in fast-moving stream. Their habitat preferences contribute to their reproductive isolation. Conservation note is that male Rana draytonii prefer large females to small females, and male Rana draytonii living in ponds occupied by introduced exotic, that is bullfrog Rana catesbiana, will often amplex with female of the larger exotic species. This result in wasted mating effort. Introduction of bullfrog to red-legged frog territory has become a conservational problem. Temporal isolation is what? Two related species occupying the same geographical range may have different periods of sexual activity or breeding seasons. For example, closely related Rana species in California coastal ecosystem, the red-legged frog Rana draytonii breeding season lasts from November to late April, and yellow-legged frog Rana belli breeding season lasts from late April to June month. The breeding season may overlap in some areas. The combination of ecological and temporal isolation prevents hybridization. Next isolation is behavioral isolation, that is, a species with complex courtship behavior usually exhibit a stereotype call and response signal between male and female before actual mating take place. These rituals prevent wasted mating effort that would halt gene transmission by inviable or infertile hybrids, so for example, birds of paradise. Now, mechanical isolation is morphological differences between species prevent hybridization. For example, snail shell coiling. This is the plate of snail shell coiling. In some snail species, the direction of shell coiling is controlled by a single maternal effect gene. And left coiling snail cannot mate with the right coiling snail. Such mutations could quickly lead to further differentiation and possibly speciation. Next is gametic isolation. So, in this case, that is, sperms and ova of the two species are chemically incompatible and will not join to form a zygote. For example, sympatric sea urchin species. Sea urchin synchronously broadcast gametes into ocean. Sperm and eggs from the same species fuse to form zygote. These develop into planktonic larvae that eventually settle to metamorphose into adult. Giant red urchin, Strongylocentrotus francisiae, Canis, and purple urchin, Strongylocentrotus purpuratus, cohabit the rocky intertidal along the western U.S. but do not interbreed. Their gametes do not recognize one another, maintaining species integrity. A post-zygotic mechanism which prevents hybrids from passing on their genes. This is the first is hybrid inviability. Sperm and egg from the two species may combine, but the genetic information is insufficient to carry the organism through the normal development. The embryo dies after a few cleavages. or some time before birth or hatching. For example, Drosophila species, despite their superficially similar appearance, Drosophila melanogaster and Drosophila simulans have incompatible alleles. For nuclear pore protein and dysfunction of this vital gene result in inviable hybrids. Next is tiger, Panthera tigris and leopard, that is Panthera pardus. Tigers and lions are sister taxa. Their hybrid offspring are viable and robust but sterile. A mating between a lion and leopard will produce sterile hybrids. A mating between a tiger and leopard will produce inviable hybrid. Zygotes divide but embryo miscarries or it is still born. Next is hybrid sterility. Example is tiger, Panthera tigris and lion, Panthera leo. Tigers and lion are sister taxa but separate for millions of years. Their hybrid offspring are viable and robust but sterile. Chromosomes are not homologous, so do not migrate normally at meiosis. Male tigris and lioness give rise to tigon. And male lion, when it gets mated with the tigris, then it produces a leger. So reciprocal cross offspring are somewhat different. Maternal and mitochondria input, maternally and paternally imprinted gene differ. Next example is horse, that is Equus caballus, and donkey, Equus asinus. Horses and donkey have been separate species for millions of years. Their hybrid offspring are viable and robust but sterile. Male horse and female donkey produces mule, and male donkey and female horses it produces hinny. As ever, a reciprocal cross offspring are somewhat different. Maternal and mitochondrial input, maternally and paternally imprinted gene differ. Hybrid breakdown means the two related species can hybridize. Their F1 offsprings are fertile, but successive generation F2 and beyond suffer lower viability or fecundity. Thus, therefore, they cannot become established population. The next is example is rice cultivar. Rice cultivars of domestic rice have been artificially selected for centuries. Some are closely related enough to hybridize. F1 hybrids are fertile and viable. F2 generation is stunted and sterile. Interspecific species hybridization, that is a hybrid zone, is a region where the geographic range of two closely related species overlap. Hybrids between the two species are known to occur. Hybridization between closely related species can have one of the several possible outcomes, that is species reinforcement. That is, hybrids have lower fitness than either parent species. Reproductive isolation is maintained due to the lack of hybrid survival or reproduction. Species fusion, that is two species in a hybrid zone, may have weak reproductive isolating barriers, and the two species may over time eventually share a common gene pool. Species stability, that is hybrid equilibrium. Hybrids are continually produced by the two parent population in a hybrid zone. A narrow hybrid zone can foster constant hybridization with reduced hybrid survival. For example, Bombina hybrid zone in Eastern Europe. Hybrid speciation, that is hybrid, may be reproductive superior to parent population. Positive assortive mating among hybrids can lead to hybrid speciation. So overall, this is the theory of evolution, which is the modern concept of evolution. So if you are not yet subscribed my channel, then please like, share and subscribe, and press the bell icon to get all videos. Thank you very much.